Really exciting day for us as a bank, obviously for Wesley as a developer here, and a big day for Seminole Heights, and I think the city of Tampa in general. You know, this project has been a couple years in the making, and is the result of a lot of hard work from the general contractors and all the subs that were involved in the project, but really a vision for this area, for Seminole Heights, for this urban core in Tampa that started a couple years ago. And today we get to celebrate kind of the fruits of that labor and the fruition of that vision. You know, it's always fulfilling for me as a banker to see projects like this happen, especially ones in our backyard. And that's what I'm most proud of here with this project. You know, we as a community bank like to invest locally in the community, and this is an opportunity for us to give back to something right here, you know, in urban Tampa, in the urban corridor, and really something that I think is going to spark the growth in Seminole Heights, and is just part of that master plan that's happening in Tampa right now as the city evolves. And so I just want to thank everybody for coming out here today and being a part of this project and being able to celebrate it with myself and everybody else that's here. And just want to get things started off, I'd like to welcome the mayor of Tampa, Mayor Buckhorn, to the stage.
First of all, welcome to everyone that's here today, to all the bankers to help pay for this, but more importantly to Wes and his team who had the vision to imagine what this could look like. It's great to see Councilmember Mike Suarez here. Thanks, Mike, for being here. But more importantly to all of you, to Wes's family, to my two new little buddies right there, who are very shy right now, and the little redhead is turning red all over, who looks just like my daughter Colleen. And I think they have the same freckles, right? But I couldn't be more excited for this project. And if you think about what we're doing here, it's basically repurposing an old building, an old obsolete building, and creating a destination. And creating a place where people will want to live, work, and play in the same environment. And ultimately, the concepts behind urbanism is to create environments where people don't have to have a car, where they can live, work, and play. And Seminole Heights is in the midst of an amazing transformation. Now, it hasn't happened overnight. It's been in the midst for the last 20 years, but certainly has accelerated over the last five, as we have seen Seminole Heights become a destination for foodies, for some of the best chefs and restaurants in our cities, for the explosion of the craft beer industry in Tampa, where we are becoming known around the world as one of the best cities for craft breweries, as evidenced by the fact that Cigar City just sold for a very significant sum of money. And we're seeing craft breweries lined up and down the streets of Florida Avenue and Nebraska Avenue and the city of Tampa to produce a great product that is helping to put us on the map. So this is one more piece of the puzzle. And just as downtown has exploded, as young people have moved back in droves to our urban core, Seminole Heights, Tampa Heights, Riverside Heights are all starting to experience the same thing. With the completion of the Riverwalk, there is a common focal point for everybody to enjoy the city. And we have exposed our urban neighborhoods in ways that 5 years ago no one would have imagined could have happened. So I am excited to be here to cut this ribbon. I am excited for entrepreneurs and developers and investors like Wes, who had the vision for what this building could be, not what it has been. And I anticipate that as Seminole Heights continues to grow and to mature, and as people can discover what an amazing neighborhood this is, with an amazing housing stock and amazing opportunities like this to make money, to create a sense of place, and to attract people into the urban core, we're going to see more and more of this up and down Florida and Nebraska avenues. I couldn't be happier. Wes, congratulations. This is your day. Come on up here.
Well, thank you so much, Bob. I appreciate the kind words. And, you know, this is obviously a very exciting day. I mean, a year ago here, this was just a dilapidated building that, you know, was leaking everywhere. And, you know, I think we had, you know, my team and myself, you know, had a vision of what this place really could be. And I think it's important, you know, to be able to go, you know, execute that vision. And now, you know, it's very fulfilling. It's very emotional to actually see, you know, what it's become, and also the support from, you know, the local area, you know, and the neighborhood behind it as well. The big part of this too, you know, it wasn't a one-person job, and there's a lot of people that I could definitely thank, but there's one person in most that I have to thank, and that would be my wife. Without Kristen, none of this would have been possible. It's, you know, this was a very consuming task in keeping the family together, and that's one thing I have not done enough is say thank you, and this is the chance I really can say, you know, thank you, Kristen, for everything. It's made the dream come true. So, you know, that being said, I mean, you know, I want everybody to kind of get a chance to look around, look through the model, you know, see the building, because it is different. This isn't a cookie cutter product. This is, you know, this is a project that is, you know, seen, you know, a little more outside the box. I mean, this is an industrial urban design product, which is something that really focused on that millennial core. We want to attract that very motivated, ambitious millennial crowd from not only inside of Tampa, for people that want to come from other cities, because this is a product that would be seen in, you know, a DC, a New York, a Chicago. And we're getting a lot of that are living here. And it's exciting to see that adaption, you know, of, hey, listen, Tampa has some cool product set. We don't have just, you know, one type of, you know, housing options here. So it's neat that we can bring in, you know, the rusticated walls and, you know, the polished concrete floors with, you know, with the finer elements, you know, nicer cabinetry, the stainless steel railings, and, you know, and the, you know, tongue and groove wood flooring, all those things coming together to kind of make something special. And it's coming through with not only how we're leasing up, but also the quality of the people that we're getting in here too. So that part is very exciting, because I think that's also how we're gonna grow. I think Seminole Heights, as Bob mentioned, you know, this is a great, you know, it's great to have this done, but there's more work to be done. We want to continue the development. We want to continue to go moving forward and, you know, taking out the car lots, taking out the dilapidated buildings. You know, it's the running joke here in Seminole Heights, but we do have a lot going on, and been asked many times, you know, Seminole Heights has, you know, gone up and down, up and down. Is this time going to be different? I believe so. This time is going to be different, and a lot of that is for multiple reasons. And this building, I think, is going to be an important part of it, but it's also because of all the other people that are investing. You're seeing more restaurants. You're seeing a wider proliferation of retail. You know, people like the Rabbit Hole, the Vintage Market Post, you know, the art galleries. Not all just the beer and the restaurants, which, by the way, you know, the best in town. But we're seeing more and more people coming in and wanting to invest. We're seeing wider areas, you know, people buying new homes. This is what gives you foundation to continue to grow. So we want to continue to develop, you know, the area. We have another project on 5208 North Giddens. That's going to be starting up here this summer. It'll be similar but different. It'll be kind of like the pretty sister of the warehouse. This is going to be the gritty old brother. That's going to be the pretty sister, you know, loft apartments, mixed use, because we really do see that as, you know, a lifeblood of how the area can kind of urbanize and kind of grow. So it's an exciting time. You know, I appreciate everybody being out here, and just let me, you know, kind of rant for this for a little bit, but it's a proud day, and I'm really excited, and thank you all for coming out and take a look around. Okay, thank you.
Yeah.